Princess Kate has announced she's completed her course of chemo. In a pretty emotional video, 7 months after announcing her cancer diagnosis to the world.
Let's go live to Joel Dry at Buckingham Palace. Joel, Kate released the message this morning as she enters a new phase of recovery.
Yes, Shervo, this was quite the surprise. We knew we were getting an update on Kate's health today from Kensington Palace, but we certainly weren't expecting this. When you think of royal announcements, you perhaps think very prim, proper, a bit stiff, perhaps a little bit stale. This certainly wasn't that. This was a candid, intimate look into the lives of the Wales family, the lives they've been leading while Kate has been enduring this cancer battle. And in this very touching video, she gave an update to the world on how it's going.
Under a summer sky, surrounded by her family, Catherine, the Princess of Wales, reflects on what's been a difficult journey.
The last 9 months have been incredibly tough for us as a family. Life as you know it can change in an instant, and we've had to find a way to navigate the stormy waters and road unknown.
Revealing a cancer diagnosis in March, months of chemotherapy followed.
This time has above all reminded William and me to reflect and be grateful for the simple yet important things in life, which so many of us often take for granted, of simply loving and being loved.
Her grueling cancer treatment now over, Kate says she's focused on being cancer-free. Looking healthy and happy, the video shows Kate enjoying the forests, fields and beaches of Norfolk with husband William and children George, Charlotte and Louis.
Is this filming?
Hello?
Hello!
The Princess of Wales giving thanks for those who've helped their young family along the way.
William and I are so grateful for the support we've received and have drawn great strength from all those who are helping us at this time. Everyone's kindness, empathy and compassion has been truly humbling.
Kate says her path back to full health is still a long one.
Despite all that's gone before, I enter this new phase of recovery with a renewed sense of hope and appreciation of life.
So there is still a fair bit in that video we don't find out. We don't know what type of cancer she has been battling, nor when exactly the treatment finished. The palace saying that is all private and it will remain so. But what we have been told is that she will now make a staged return to full public duties. Just a handful of events over the coming months, including Remembrance Sunday in November and then hosting a Carols event in December. But however slowly she takes it, I think everyone is just happy to see her back doing what she does.
Yeah, absolutely. And you're right, there's not a lot of new information, but she's owning it and she's doing it her way and she can. So good on her. Thank you, Joel.
Now to Canberra, and the Prime Minister will today reveal legislation to help keep Australian children safe from social media.
Live to Isabel Mullen now. Izzy, this is about enforcing age limits on platforms like Instagram and TikTok.
It is, Nat and Shervo, good morning. An exact age limit hasn't yet been set, but it's expected to be around 14 to 15 years old. The Prime Minister says this is about reducing exposure to disturbing content, things like deepfake pornography, but also online bullying. This has been announced in Victoria and South Australia, so it is a national ban following those announcements in the states. It would likely need cooperation from these big social media companies like TikTok. We know they've been really resistant to this sort of government intervention in the past. The Prime Minister is proposing big fines for companies that don't comply. They do have currently an age limit of about 13, but that is quite easy to get around, so this would operate differently. The Coalition says it supports this in principle, but would like the age limit to be 16. Guys.
Okay. Thank you, Izzy.
And the Prime Minister will join us live after 7 a.m. on his pledge to ban addictive apps for kids.
Right now, though, let's get some more news. Here's Mon.
Shervo, thank you. The father of one of three children left fighting for life after a Sydenham house fire says the horror incident shouldn't have happened. Police are investigating if the children had been home alone when firefighters pulled three children under five unconscious from the house. All children remain in a critical condition in hospital where they're being treated for smoke inhalation this morning. A man who poured hot coffee on a baby in a Brisbane park has fled the country as police vow to hunt him down at all costs. Live to Georgie Chumley in Brisbane. Now, Georgie, this manhunt is now an international one.
Good morning, Mon. That's right. Around 30 specialist police are involved in trying to track down this man. The Australian Federal Police have revealed some of his movements in the lead up to him leaving the country. We know that he immediately fled the scene of the crime in a car. He went to New South Wales and laid low for around 4 days before catching an international flight out of Sydney on the 31st of August. Now, police didn't find out his identity until 12 hours after he left the country, when it was simply too late. The little boy in question, the nine-month-old, well, he remains in hospital. He's undergone multiple surgeries, including skin grafts. The parents, well, they've come out saying they're in part relieved that this man won't attack anyone else in Australia, but they're still asking themselves the question why their little boy was targeted.
Mom. Yeah, of course they are. All right, Georgie Chumley for us there in Brisbane. Thank you. NRL star Josh Adokar could miss this week's do or die final, with Canterbury Bulldogs bosses confirming that police are now investigating allegations that he tested positive to cocaine during a roadside drug test. Live to Lucy McLeod in Bulldogs Heartland in Belmore. So, Lucy, what happens now?
Well, the club is in crisis talks this morning, Mon, about whether to allow Josh Adokar to play in the Bulldogs' first final in 8 years. Now, it was Friday night that Josh Adokar was pulled over and tested positive for cocaine in a roadside drug test. He was then taken for a second sample but allowed to drive away as police await that further analysis. It sent the club into a spin. Initially, Phil Gould, the club's general manager, backed the star winger, saying that there is nothing to the rumours. Now the club is investigating, and this is what he had to say on 100% Footy last night.
I think Josh deliberately misled us. I think his interpretation of the events was obviously his own interpretation and inaccurate, but it's probably led to now where it's hard to trust anything about that, and it looks like there's been some sort of cover-up from us and him, which is not the case.
Now, Josh Adokar, of course, maintains his innocence. So far, no charges have been laid.
Mom. All right, Lucy, thank you. In breaking news, disgraced Hollywood producer Harvey Weinstein has been rushed to hospital in New York for emergency heart surgery. The 72-year-old was taken from jail to a local hospital for treatment. Weinstein was convicted of rape and sexual assault in 2020. He was jailed for 23 years. Footy fans are in for a grand final parade that's being hailed as bigger and better than ever. Let's go live to Andrew McCormack in Melbourne. Now, Macca, we're getting our first look at the new route. Where will it go?
Morning, Mon. That's right. It'll start at Grand Slam Oval here and make its way through Melbourne Park down towards Birrarung Mara at a live site alongside the Yarra River, with screens for fans to get up close to their favourite players. It'll then make its way over a walkway down towards the MCG, where in Yarra Park the traditional footy festival live site will finish the parade on stage, with players presented to fans with the Premiership Cup. The two captains, of course, lifting the cup as per tradition. Some 250,000 fans is the estimate for this year's parade. The parade route designed by the AFL, they've called it and described it as a more fan-friendly route. Of course, it'll finish on grand final eve, that public holiday. So massive crowds expected. That parade route set to be confirmed later today by the AFL. Mon.
Okay, thanks so much, Macca. Well, we think that this next story is pretty incredible. Australia's favourite blue heeler, Bluey, has officially been crowned the most viewed streaming series in America. OK, we were going to go to live to Tamra Bowe, who's on the Gold Coast, who's super excited. Tamra, are you there? This is big news, particularly for Queensland, where Bluey, of course, is shot.
I'm on absolutely smashing it out of the ballpark. This is just incredible stuff. Bluey is now top dog in the US, sitting pretty at the top of the pile, right where it belongs, and racking up some incredible watch time as well. We now know that little Bluey fans and their mums and dads have watched an incredible 35 billion minutes of the kids' program in the last 12 months alone, shooting it to the top spot in the US. And to have a little bit of a humble brag, the co-founder has taken to social media, and that has garnered some pretty cute views, including from the American Embassy in Australia, Mon. It says all of our kids now use the word dunny and they all absolutely love it. How cute is that?
Yep, we should be very, very proud, especially about the dunny. Thanks so much, Tamara. Well, Apple has just unveiled its brand new tech, and while it's normally the iPhones that generate the most excitement, another popular product has stolen the show. Sunrise tech editor Sean White is on the ground as a guest of Apple at the company's headquarters in California. Now, Sean, apparently Apple's new iPods, they're the talk of the town. Why?
Sorry, did you just say iPods?
Was that what you meant?
They're actually AirPods, but yeah, that was a good one, Mon. Are you playing?
Should I say iPods?
We're actually talking about the AirPods.
I actually don't know the difference.
iPods are quite a few years back, but I think, you know, that makes
sense.
Anyway,
you never know.
Those AirPods that go in your ear, they are actually coming with a new update that actually can, well, make them into hearing aids. So big news there. You could even do a hearing test if you needed to check your hearing, Mon. Then we've also got two new smartwatches coming as well, the Series 10, which will have sleep apnea detection capabilities. But that iPhone lineup, the 16, will come with that Apple intelligence we heard about earlier in the new year, raising the IQ level for those phones. They start at $1,399, and the most expensive is over $2,000. They are actually cheaper than last year.